Hello everyone, so myself Dr. Nivedita, working as consultant doctor at Colors Healthcare. Well, today, as I said, we'll be having a brief discussion on obesity and stress and how exactly it impacts our health. So I'm here to answer your questions if you've got any queries regarding this. So what exactly is this obesity? And in the present times, obesity is one of the serious illness which is being faced among so many individuals, irrespective of their age and sex. So as we all know, obesity is nothing but accumulation of fat. So how exactly it leads to, and when do we call a person who is obese? So why do we give this criteria obese? So there is something called as body mass index. So body mass index can be calculated by measuring the person's height in centimeters divided by, again, that is their height which has been squared. So exactly how we exactly get is the weight in kgs divided by height in centimeters which has been squared. So we get a certain value. So when do we tell the person is healthy is? So 18 to 25 range, the person is healthy. So usually 25 to 29, the BMI is, the persons are usually overweight. So above 29, we call them obese. So usually like above 29, when they are called obese, so they're usually too much for their height. So that's the reason body mass index. So depending on the physical structure of a human, when they are usually weighing too much, depending on their height, and the mass is nothing but weight. So the value which is more, so that is nothing but they being obese. So people do have this query telling that, you know, why are they getting obese? So there are many factors. It is not always excessive eating a person gets obese. So there are many factors like family and inheritance factors, which would be leading to, you know, heredity, like genes which they would have inherited from their parents, and that being leading to them to be obese. So others like, you know, unhealthy diet. So when people are getting evolved into some different lifestyle, they start getting habituated to unhealthy food. So unhealthy diet intake, which would they start having a lot of junk. So so much height cost to reduce the weight, and how normal person. So normal persons, yes, they can take a treatment. It is not that always, you know, a person who's very tall or something should be taking a treatment. So people who are very much normal to maintain their fitness can also maintain their health by maintaining through diet and stuff. So coming to again this criteria, other than criteria, we've been got like, you know, people who have been very much inactive. So among right now, 70% of the population have been habituated to the sedentary lifestyle. So getting habituated to sedentary lifestyle, people start forgetting the physical activity. So people forgetting their physical activity, they just go on working, and again that leads to accumulation of fat. Because they start intaking more calories instead of burning the calories what they eat. So that excess calories will be stored as nothing but fat. So I have a question. So yes, normal people do can take the treatment you have. It is not expensive as such. So you would be having different cost ranges you would be taking the treatment. So before even discussing about the cost or price of any treatment, we would be talking just about what exactly is this. So it's nothing but an awareness talk what we are having today. So and how exactly obesity is being related to stress. So obesity and stress, they are always interlinked. So stress is nothing but an emotional feeling, and that usually happens, you know, when you start thinking too much of that particular thought or at that moment when you have that feeling. So when a person is in stress, they are so very depressed that they start thinking too much, or they get into a comfort eating zone where they start eating too much of sugars, forgetting everything, so that they start finding their happiness in eating that food. And that is how, again, that leads to them put on weight. And coming again to obesity, how is it overlinked to stress is? So people who are obese, who enter into any functions or enter into any social or economic issues, or when people are socializing through any events, what happens is people start commenting them, seeing them. So which is really, you know, not bad. But people start getting depressed listening to that. So they start getting embarrassed. So that again makes them think too much, which is again a type of stress. So these obesity and coming to stress, they are always interlinked. So I have a person who's asking this question. So saying high cost of eating is going to be. See, it's not about high cost, or this is just a process. So you'll have to go through. So as I've said, I'm from Colors. You people can come. So we are always there to help you out, and we can always give you a particular treatment plan. It's need not always be a treatment, procedural treatment. So we have different variations plans which can be given to you. And in the present situations, like because of COVID, there are people who are very much scared to travel as of now. People are worried to travel from one place to other place just because of this COVID-19. We've come up with this virtual weight loss programs as well, so that they would be helping you. They would be avoiding you to travel, and they would also save a lot of time for you so that you can go ahead. So again, coming how it exactly impacts on our health, obesity and stress. So one's mental health is very much important, and physical health as well. So being obese and stressed, what happens is, so when they are overlinked or interlinked to each other, the person that particular person starts being mentally ill so much, they start getting depressed. So they're been affecting their mental health. So that should not happen. So how exactly we can prevent all this, and what we can do, at least from our side, is nothing but, you know, you need to start opting healthy options like exercising every day. So, and coming to, you know, we know some weakness points of our food traps. So we should avoid our food traps for that. And also start doing something which is very much consistent. So as we all know, we start doing it for 1 day or 2 day or a week and you forget. So that is very much wrong. So something which we start should always be consistent, so that our body gets habituated to that particular thing. And people should make it a lifestyle habit, so that, you know, how you work every day. So anything what you do should be a great and a consistent move when you're taking something. So other than this, okay, what exactly happens when a person is obese? So what it leads to? See, person being obese is not just a matter that you're being, you know. So someone asked. So person being just obese is not that, you know, they are being fat or people are commenting or nothing like that. So it mainly leads to some issues like medical problems. And right now in the present generation, it is so obesity is not just an aesthetic concern. It is also becoming a medical problem, because it leads to many health issues like heart diseases. You have again type 2 diabetes, which is being affected. So someone been talking Telugu. So yes, I can talk in Telugu. So you can ask me a question so that I can talk in Telugu and explain you. See, reducing 5 kg weight in 1 month, it might be possible, because it depends again from a patient to patient. See, if your weight is something like too much for your body, which is something more abnormal, yes, definitely we can reduce that weight of 5 kg. But if you're already in a minimal range, if you're a healthy kid or in a normal healthy range, you know, it's difficult. So we usually need to see your range, that is body mass index. Depending on that, we usually calculate and how exactly you reduce your weight. So it all depends on your BMI. So we also do this body composition analysis, so that we get to know what percentage of fat is being there in your body, what percentage of water is being present. So when we assess all this, yes, we do get to know that, you know, people who are being something abnormal, we can reduce 5 kg. That's not a big deal. So complete efforts from your side. And yes, so one more question. Stress is a reason for overweight. Yes, stress at times is a reason for overweight. Because, you know, when people start thinking too much and when they are depressed. See, as I told you, there are many reasons. When you start thinking too much, for your personal reasons might be, you start overeating too much. That too, overeating, like, only the foods what you start liking. So something like, you know, a lot of sugar foods, a lot of food maybe which is rich in calories. So other than that, if you are a person who's on some medications like antidepressants or antipsychotic drugs or on steroids or something, then yes, you would definitely have to see to a doctor, or we would be helping you out and giving you a particular treatment plan according to your health conditions. So again, coming back to this, as I said, okay, so there are, as I said, obesity would be leading to, you know, many other health issues. So everyone, you know, it's high time right now so that we start taking care of our health. So we should start doing something like from the first moment so that, you know, we get into a right proper track and people start getting into a fitness track. So again, coming to the treatment plans. So I, being a consultant doctor at Colors, yes, we've got weight loss treatments. So again, you have skin and hair treatments in that. So coming to weight loss, see, obesity and stress, this is what I've given you an invitation. I mean, this is what I'm just giving you an awareness talk, basically. And it's a brief, you know, you people have to know what exactly is happening and what exactly, you know, how exactly obesity and stress have been overlinked. So there's a question, does exercise in the evening does to help in lose weight? See, exercising in the morning or evening doesn't matter, but exercising for the body, that definitely matters. So you need to have a particular time which you have been consistent. It might be morning or it might be in the evening which you can do it. So there is nothing like time limit. You need to exercise only in the morning or exercise only in the evening. The only thing is there needs to be a particular time gap post your lunch or post your breakfast, or when you do it in the early morning, that doesn't give you a option. That's fine. You can just continue. Yes, if we don't take proper food on time, that would lead to obesity. So there are many people, yes, it was a good question, so someone asked me. So, you know, when people start skipping their food, it might be because of any reason. Maybe they might be busy with their own work or something like that. But what happens is, so there is something called as gastritis. So this gastric juices starts getting accumulated when you're not eating on time. And that makes you not eat properly. Usually you don't eat on time. Again, you skip that meal or you eat it very much late. Again, that might lead to overeating, or you might have other issues like, you know, vomiting. And so again, this gastric issues which should be leading you to take again more of medications. So you need to do that. You need to avoid all such things. So it's better you start taking food on time so that even you maintain your gut health accordingly. So if you're not taking food on time, your gut health is going to be again damaged, so that, you know, you don't take proper food. And even when you're taking food, it usually does not get digested properly. And that might lead to even diarrhea also. So having food on time is definitely better. And if you're not taking proper food, again, proper food in the sense healthy food, you'll have to take. If you're taking again in a wrong time, when you're having again the wrong food instead of healthy food, you start having junk or a lot of sugar foods, that's very much wrong thing which is done by people right now. So any other questions? So people do ask me this, yes, when they start, you know, losing weight, ma'am, do we gain it back or something like that? So see, gaining back is nothing but you start again overeating or something, you're something skipping, or you're against doing something against your schedule or something. If you're not maintaining, yes, definitely that comes back to normal. So you need to maintain it even after you lose weight or something like that. You need to maintain a particular, you know, synchronization when you're doing something. You, as I said, you need to habituate, or you need to make that as a habit of every day you start getting habituated, good, healthy lifestyle. So yes, I would be concluding with this for today. So as I said, So colors would be there to help you at any time through our weight loss programs and also through any kind of skin and hair treatments. So people who are unable to travel can usually go through with this virtual weight loss programs, and do visit the nearby centers and you can get complete information, and there would be doctors and the dietitians who would be definitely helping you out. Thank you.